Behind all these closed doors live some of the most famous people from stage and screen from the last 40 years.
See you on the other side, you goddamn cracker ass.
Jack Nicholson.
Fuck
Joe Pesci.
Hey, Billy. I'm a smart fucking rotten Mandarin.
Jimmy Hill.
It is a good atmosphere here.
Al Pacino.
Get yourself down a sharp.
And the Rolling Stones.
Here, what you done with all those tins of cling pooches?
Yeah.
That's David Bowie.
I can't get over this street, you know, it's like living in LA.
Stella Street is the first home I've ever had.
Remember, Beverly Hills was hell.
Dear Joe, remember Billy? We are coming to stay with you for a whole month. We hear you're living in a lovely English house.
Yeah, sure.
We look forward to arriving at Heathrow at 4 p.m. Wednesday. With love, Mama.
Oh, your freezer's looking well stocked, Keith, isn't it? Cool. Ocean pie. Serves one. Do you know, I always find that a little bit sad.
Oh, well.
Here, what's that bleeding racket? You got Billy Graham out there?
You wouldn't believe what's going on in here, man.
Oh, yeah.
He's Mick, man. He's fallen into the arms of God.
Blessed are the meek. They're really nice little people.
Shut up.
Keith, where's that holy water that I ordered? It should be here by now.
I just doshed some Jack into it, man. You know, still a better chance of getting to heaven, you know?
That was top-notch holy water, that is. I ordered it especially from the Vatican.
Morning, Jack. Just admiring your garden there. That is a nice little rockery.
Rockery? Jesus Christ. This guy comes around here, he calls himself a landscape gardener. So he walks in with his wheelbarrow and charges me $575 for a bunch of rocks. You know what I call that? I call that a fuckery.
He's a yank.
Here, you know what you need? You want a cascade with some gardenias around the side and maybe even some nice little pansies.
Hey, Mike, why don't you get yourself a life, huh?
Do you know, you're right. I need to have a look at myself.
I might even get some counselling.
Just go and get yourself a life, huh? God damn.
You see this house here? The one with a Ponzi aggregate? Well, that belongs to my old mate Roger Moore. You remember Simon Templar and James Bond? Well, that's him. And do you know why I hang round with him? Because he makes me look good. She's been rubbing that for 5 days. I wouldn't be surprised if a bleating genie popped out of his head. Do you know, if you sit in the sun all bleating day, you're going to wrinkle up like a prune.
I've had a suntan all my life. You wouldn't want to see me going pasty now, would you?
Now, Rog, this isn't the cost of bleeding brava. We all get pasty in London.
Now, who the fuck are you calling pasty, you fuck?
Right, I'm going to give away all my worldly goods.
Oh.
Well, maybe not all of them. I'm going to keep the house in Chelsea, okay? Because it's handy for Earl's Court, because I'm probably going to be doing some rallies there.
Listen, you can't be the fucking Pope. You're from Dartford.
Oh,
you've
yeah,
lost you're... it, man, and you fucking lost me for the rest of the day. I'm off round the pub.
Oh, yes, thou shalt go forth to the pub, but what profit it hath?
I'm too pissed to hear what you're saying.
Verily, Keith, you shall be smote.
So what? I already smell like a kipper.
He's a lost soul.
Hey, Roger, open up, you cardigan fuck.
Hello, Joe. I was just filling in the O's on my crossword.
Guess who's coming to stay with me?
The Duchess of Kent?
No, my fucking mother. She sees the state my place is in, she's gonna kill me.
Well, I've got a meeting with the Rose Society at 10. I could give you a window.
Nah, I need 10 fucking windows.
I got 24 hours to make this place look less like the headquarters of Hezbollah.
Yes, well, there is a design rhino. I believe it was used by dear Wilfred Hyde White and Robert Morley. Now, let's talk colors. What would you say to sunrise pink and Tuscan peach?
Yeah, pink. Peach, yeah, the kind of womany, faggoty colours. So when my mother leaves, I can get the place repainted so it doesn't look like I'm taking it up the ass.
Quite so. Well, perhaps we might turn our attention to more masculine colours. What would you say to Tony Curtis Green?
Tony fucking Curtis? Some like it up the fucking ass, Tony Curtis? No, fuck Green. Looks like fucking grass. So when she's in the house, she thinks she's in the fucking garden. No, I got it.
black.
Old age has made you really spiteful, you know that, Jack?
Yeah, really.
Yeah, I bet you was really nice and warm when you was young, making them films like
Five Easy Pieces. She's a guy. She's such a fucking guy.
This is Hoggett. My name is Sally, and I'm 22, okay?
Oh, I bet you are, girl.
Look, now, Mrs. H, I'm trying to take a fucking shower.
With that paunch on you, you should get yourself down the car wash, Jack.
Christ's sake,
Mrs. You seen it?
Your ass is so old, it's decided to hit the ground and stay there.
Oh.
So why don't you get out of here and go into my room and wiggle it around a little and try and pick up some of that dust you left there last time.
Okay.
Come on.
You want some dusting? Here, you want to help me with the dusting?
Christ! Oh no, the devil's dandruff. $500 worth of nose candy in the goddamn Bex Bissell.
What would you say to Red?
Red? Yes, of course. Yeah, with a roulette table right in the middle, huh?
Does your mother like games?
What are you fucking talking about? Buy the syringe? Golden showers? It's my mother we're talking about here, not some fucking hooker.
I thought you wanted a gambling ambulance.
You'll be needing a fucking ambulance. You're gambling with your fucking life.
Oh. Yes, well, I just thought, Joe, you might like something cushy and comfortable so that you could relax and...
Like to lie down?
Yes, if you like.
What, with my mother? You incestuous sick fuck. Get the fuck out of my beautiful house. Mind me your fucking tread.
Oh, hello, Mixie.
Hello, Dave.
I've just been giving some thought to the depth of your kidney here.
Right. Now, so have I.
Yeah.
What I'd like is 6'7", up this end of the kidney.
Hug it out.
Sloping up. Come here. Sloping up to 1 foot. At the shallow end, in case we have any kids around.
It's funny you're talking about kids, you know, because...
Why?
I was wondering whether you had any nicknames when you was a kid.
What are you worried about that for?
I just want to know, you know, I mean, did they call you sort of lanky four eyes, you know?
You're having a laugh, aren't you?
Or big tall Michael Caine.
No, I was not.
No.
They called me Mr. Caine.
Yeah. Oh, beep! Oh, no, a bit of a mistake there, Michael. Because you were actually Maurice Micklewhite from Bermondsey. Can I call you Maurice, Mixie?
Do you know the reason why I left Bermondsey?
No.
To get away from mouthy little toe rags like you.
Oh, yeah, so I see. So now you're rich and famous, what? You can't talk to your own kind no more. Well, I can understand that, you know.
Oh, you can understand
that,
can you?
Yeah, I can, I suppose.
Because you're rich and famous and you would understand
no,
that.
No, I'm not.
Because you're just a dozy little builder. I don't know why I bloody bother to hire you. Please, Dean, do yourself a favour. Get on with my bloody kidney.
At least I didn't work in the swarm.
Right, that's locked. Yes, it's locked. And the
mortar,
it's all locked.
Oh, listen, don't you go drinking none of that water unless it's in a bottle, all right?
No, I've got 6 litres of Campsie Spring with me, so I should be all right. Here, and look after Fluffy, won't you? She's my pride and joy.
I will.
I'm off to the Congo now. Here, we couldn't get Walter Matthau, so we got Claude Van Damme. Be nice to go somewhere up, wouldn't it?
Hello, Michael. All right, son.
You look a bit peaky, Dave. Have you been up all night or something?
Nah, it's my new foundation. Here, do you think it makes me look a bit buttery? So what are you doing, son? You going on holiday or something?
No. I'm off to the Congo to make a film.
Oh, nice one. Be nice, that. It'd be hot, wouldn't it? Here, have you heard about Mick? He's got God. I've been searching for years.
The kingdom of God is within.
Do you know, I never thought of that. There's me, all them years, looking for it outside somewhere, and it's in there.
I can't stand round here all day discussing comparative religions. I have got a plane to catch. See you, son.
Bye, Michael.
Yeah, bye, Don. See you later.
I love you like my own son. You know that?
Yes. That's why he topped himself. Listen, your glasses are gone.
Oh.
Broken.
Oh.
Go and get them fixed, girl, because you'll be bumping into things for a change, won't you?
Yeah.
Love ya.
You gave me some bloody money. I'd get them fixed, wouldn't I?
I'm missing you already.
Heard such language as comes out of the mouth of Joe. It's I think he's got a problem. I mean, if he weren't so famous and does all these films, they'd have put him in a home.